good off the restart so far this week, but not so good there. The defence on the man that Carlton Arna just mentioned from the kickoff, Ronald Brown, getting around the outside. He's not the biggest bloke there, but he got the fin when he needed. What a start for the Blitzbocker.
Oh, he's big an effort. That's what matters for Ronald Brown. Yeah, sure, he might be a slight player, but I like the way he backs himself. Bends right to the chest on the bigger man. Switches the ball over, knows he doesn't need the second fin with the sweeper to come in across. But geez, the confidence of the young man, supreme.
Just the start South Africa were looking for. Gets a chance to convert his own work too. Going to be away to the right, but a cracking start for the series leaders. 5 points to nil. What a story this young man is.
Yeah, had to deal with some adversity, some health issues. That's Ronald Brown, but you know what? He's worked hard. He's gotten himself into supreme condition, and now he is making a statement here.
Umar sends that high, and well brought down by Henry Hutchinson. Brought up 100 tries in the previous match, the fourth Australian to do so. Change of tactic here from Australia with a kick downfield, trying to find open spaces, and the bounce is ugly for Umar, but great for Turner and the offload as well for Malouf, who looks to spread over Roach. Tool just going to back himself as he's done all season, Corey Tool. Offload for Roach, and then again straight up through the middle is the big, strong, striding figure of Ben Maher. Pace and power, and Australia strike right back.
Yeah, what about that? From this Aussie outfit, the change-up with the kick. South Africa had their defense up, so they saw a lot of space in behind. It was a good chase on it too. Watch him here, he was the only one. Wicked bounce. And then they get out the head numbers there. This is what I like, a pull out from Nick Luke. Realizes there's a lot of space on the outside. That's a good pass for Corey Tool. That's a nice angle from the 13. Ben Maher, that's a well-constructed try by this Wallabies outfit.
Conversion in front for the series leading scorer, Dietrich Roach. So Australia go ahead, 7 points to 5. It's been an all-action, I think,
day long, and you're going to need some more from him. This Aussie team are going to get up to South Africa. So they look very cool and calm and collected, and always in that huddle. You know, it's always going to come down the moment. The Australians talking about the line speed of the South African defence, being able to handle that, slide off that, and then attack from there.
Delvin Davis onto the field for South Africa at halftime, and he will have the restart. 7 minutes to play on day one. Who will top pull C? South Africa will try to be tricky. Let it bounce. Cleverly done by Zane Davis. And now look at those big thighs charging forward, pumping the legs. It allows South Africa to spin straight onto attack. Davis for Umar. Tried to rip it away to Tool, and yet it was just a small knock on. The Australians saw him, and so did the referee. Australian defence was good.
I just have to be so aware. Don't you? The Australians were caught napping there initially from their restart. From Davis there, punching it along the ground. It was good reaction from Zane Davis. Get that ball. See, 1-2 at the moment in the series. South Africa leading. Aussie second. Always know it's going to be a heavyweight battle in the group so far.
Australia third and Singapore second after Bill Thorpe. Now he's up to the top spot. Yeah, but you've got to love the work that Sean Menenti's doing with this young Aussie team. You look. It was who fed the stuff. Now Roach standing in midfield, and there's some more heavy contact. Turner goes to ground. He's able to lay it back and headlong into Stilton Fonfay. And now Koizuapi rushes up on Tool, misses. Davis misses as well. Sweeper coming across on Corey Tool, shakes the kick, cops back in field, and then the inside ball for Roach's support. He's not going to have enough wheels to get there, but he's got the support for Gonzalez, who is absolutely hammered from behind. Didn't hear the footsteps coming. Marin's support, though, for Australia has done really well to get there to help out Gonzalez. And Australia break out from deep inside their own 22. And it's the skipper on the end of the chain, Nick Maloof, scores to extend Australia's lead.
Well, it just shows you the danger of Corey Tool. Shakes Koizuapi, try to jam him in. It has some good footwork. Zane Davis got to get across. He's pointing on the infield. Maybe he's going to shake the kick. Side's better. Get the ball in hand, and from there, the Aussies, it's always easier coming forward. They had the numbers on the outside, and they go coast to coast to the Aussies.
Skipper, look of intensity to his young charges. Richard Roach sized up the options well, was able to hold it up. Good support play. Conversion away, though. That's a handy lead for Australia. 19 points to 10 now.
African skipper out to JC Pretorius